So next I'd like to move on to the cervix. So what we're looking at here is the cervix bulging into the end of the vagina. So the portion of the cervix projecting into the vagina is known as the ectocervix. And I've outlined this in blue. And then you've got the bit which lines this canal running inside the cervix. So this is the endocervical canal. So you've got the ectocervix and the endocervix. So the endocervix is lined with columnar epithelium, whereas the ectocervix, which is continuous with the vagina, is lined with squamous epithelium. So where the columnar epithelium meets the squamous epithelium is called the squamocolumnar junction. So during pregnancy and during puberty, you get eversion of the cervix. So you get the pushing out of these columnar cells which line the endocervix. And as a result, they're then exposed to the acidic environment of the vagina. So what happens when the columnar epithelium are exposed to this acidic environment is that you get metaplasia, which is a changing of the cell type from columnar to squamous epithelium. And this area of change from columnar to squamous is called the transformation zone. And this zone is important because at this area, the cervix is susceptible to neoplastic change and ultimately to the possibility of cervical carcinoma. So a common benign condition to be aware of is a cervical ectropion, which is also called a cervical erosion. So like I just mentioned, during puberty and during pregnancy, the cervix protrudes out and you get exposure of the columnar cells to the vagina. So on speculum examination, you can see the ectropion or erosion around the cervical os, and it's visible as a sort of reddish area. So this is a normal finding in younger women, pregnant women, and those women who are using the pill. And it often presents with post-coital bleeding, so that's bleeding after intercourse. So two other important conditions to talk about are the pre-malignant, pre-invasive stage of cervical cancer, which is called cervical intraepithelial neoplasia, and the other is malignant carcinoma of the cervix. So on the left here, I've drawn a very quick diagram of a layer of epithelial cells sitting upon the basement membrane. So invasive cancer is cancer that has spread through the basement membrane. So cervical intraepithelial neoplasia, or CIN, is this pre-invasive stage of cervical cancer. So it hasn't yet gone through the basement membrane. So in this pre-malignant condition, you've got atypical cells, you've got dysplastic cells. And the way that it's detected is often with a smear test. So a smear test is a cytological test where cells are sampled from this transformation zone of the cervix, which is the most common origin or location for cells to go under this dysplastic change. So it's important to note that the smear is a cytological test. It detects cellular changes rather than histological changes. But the degree of dyskaryosis, which is the degree of cellular change, actually reflects the severity of the CIN, the cervical intraepithelial neoplasia. And these cellular changes are changes in the nuclear size and also changes in the rate of mitotic division. So essentially, it's a histological diagnosis, but the cellular changes do correspond to what is actually seen on histology. So there are three grades of CIN. So in grade one, you've got mild dysplasia, and this affects the lower third of the epithelium. In CIN two, you've got moderate dysplasia, which affects the lower two thirds of the epithelium. And in CIN three, you've got full thickness involvement of the epithelium. So this is called carcinoma in situ. So at this stage, if the abnormal cells invade through the basement membrane, you have cervical cancer. So in cervical carcinoma, it most often occurs near the external os at the transformation zone. And one of the most common causes is the human papillomavirus, HPV. And 90% of the time, cervical carcinoma is of this squamous type, so it's squamous cell carcinoma, or SCC. And then the second most common type is adenocarcinoma, which involves cells of glandular origin. So those are some important conditions to be aware of in relation to the cervix.